And therefore, all these politicians are a set of rogues and rascals who have looted the country, who divide the people on caste and religious lines for their vote banks, and they deserve to be shot.
Can we say it is the BJP who leads the present government?
BJP divides people on religious lines, other parties divide people on caste lines. I make no difference. All the politicians, they are rogues and scoundrels. They have, it's so sad, such a great country is in the hands of gundas. These are nothing but gundas, criminals. And they all deserve to be hanged, all our politicians. This country is heading for a revolution. Just imagine, prices are shooting up the roof. 200 rupees a kilo dal. What is the price of onions? What is the price of mustard oil? Unemployment is increasing. Massive unemployment in the country. The crisis, it is all heading towards a crisis. When there will be a revolution in this country.
So you mean you see no hope presently?
I see hope. A revolution is my hope. You see, there can be one building which can be repaired or renovated. There can be another building which is so dilapidated that you have to, it requires demolition and fresh construction. So, there is no construction without destruction. You have to destroy this system. It is outdated. Our constitution has exhausted itself. All our institutions have collapsed. Do we have a parliament? The whole monsoon session was washed out. Shouting, screaming, there was no business transacted. I am sure that is going to happen in the winter session and thereafter in the budget session. Parliament is finished. It will never work now. Whoever is in opposition will not allow the parliament to function. When BJP was in opposition, they did not allow parliament to function. Now, Congress and others, I know, they will not allow it to. Parliament is finished. Judiciary, it takes 25-30 years to decide a case finally. Is this a judiciary or a joke? And half of the judiciary has become corrupt. I know, I was part of the system. Bureaucracy is largely corrupt. Everything has collapsed in this country. Now then, it is all a empty shell, hollow. So, it requires a revolution.
By revolution, you mean revolution in real meaning or some change in the system?
Yes, change. Real meaning is complete change. We have to have a just social order where the standard of living of the people is rising. You see, the test of every system is one and only one. Is the standard of living of the masses rising in that system or not? Whether you call it capitalism or socialism or communism or any ism, the test is only one. Is the standard of living of the masses rising or not? So, we have to create a system in which the standard of living of the masses keeps rising. That can only come by a revolution. Therefore, the solution to our country's problems do not lie within the system, they lie outside the system, which means the system has to be destroyed. This system will not allow progress to take place. You are seeing prices are rising, unemployment is rising. All this talk of Vikas has proved to be hollow. Where is the development? So it was all a fraud.
You said about corruption. Also, we discussed about communalism. What is more dangerous?
See, both are dangerous and they are complementary to each other. This is a country of great diversity. So many religions, so many castes, so many languages, so many ethnic groups. So the only way to keep united and progress is secularism and giving equal respect to everybody. So, communalism is an enemy of this nation. All those who are communal are traitors to this nation, enemies. And similarly, casteism is also an enemy to the nation. Corruption is also an enemy to the nation. At every level, there is corruption in this country. So, very tough measures have to be taken, which is not possible within the system. It is when some kind of, like in the French Revolution, when it came, then they guillotined all these aristocrats. They cut off their necks. You have to do the same because these fellows, these politicians are incorrigible. They cannot be reformed. They have to be shot or hanged. They will not change them like a leopard who cannot change his spots. These politicians will not change their nature. They have no genuine love for the country. They only want their vote banks, for which they spread hatred, polarize people. So are they not enemies of the country who divide people and make people fight with each other?